Good morning and Jai Hind. In this video, I am going to discuss the next case in the issue of share, that is forfeiture of shares issued at premium. I have taken this question from the exercise given in the chapter Issue of Share in a book written by D.K. Goyal of Company's Account. So first, let us read the question. Vikram Limited issued 50,000 shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 1 per share, payable as follows. So 50,000 shares were issued at 11 rupees. The face value would be 10 rupees and there is a premium of 1 rupee, that means total 11 rupees. 3 were asked on the application, 4 on allotment including premium, and 2 on first call, and the balance, that means 2 rupees in the second and the final call. Applications were received for rupees 46,000 and all of them were accepted. Directors did not make the final call, that means this is a case of undersubscription. Out of 50,000, only 46,000 shares were applied. A shareholder holding 800 shares did not pay the amount due on the first call. So there is a call of error also there, that a shareholder who has 800 shares was failed to pay the first call money. The shares were forfeited and reissued at 7 rupees per share, 8 per share paid. Okay, now what happened? As the shareholder was unable to pay or failed to pay the first call money, so his shares were forfeited and they were reissued. All 800 shares were forfeited and reissued at rupees 7. So let us see how to make the journal entries and prepare the cash book. So the first entry would be the receiving of application by the company. So the bank account debit to share application account, and in this we have to enter the amount by multiplying 46,000 into 3. We get 1,38,000, which is to be written in the debit and credit column. Next is for the transfer of shares. So share application account debit to equity share capital account, and the same amount of 1,38,000 is to be entered here also. Now it's time for calling allotment money. So the entry would be equity share allotment account debit to equity share capital account to security premium reserve. As in this question, the company has asked 1 rupees per share as a premium, so that would be entered by the name securities premium reserve. And for this we can calculate 1 into 46,000, the amount would be 46,000, should be written in the credit side. Next thing, that is amount which is called by the company at the time of allotment, is 1,84,000, which could be calculated by multiplying 4 rupees into 46,000, and the actual cost of price of the share is 1,38,000, that means 3 rupees into 46,000, because there is a premium of 1 rupee. Next is for the receipt of the allotment money, that means bank account debit to equity share allotment account, and as it is fully paid, so 1,84,000 has been received by the company. Now it's time for the first call, equity share first call account debit to equity share capital account. Here on the first call, 2 rupees were asked by the company, so it could be calculated by multiplying 2 rupees into 46,000, we get 92,000. And next entry would be the receipt of the first call money. bank account debit to equity share first call account. As in a question, it is given that a shareholder who contains 800 shares of a company was failed to submit the first call money. So we can calculate the amount which were not received by the company by multiplying 800 into 2 rupees. That means 1600 rupees were not received by the company, by the shareholder who has 800 shares. So we can calculate the amount which is received by the company actually by subtracting 1600 from 92,000. It comes 90,400 rupees, which should be entered here. Next is that as it is decided by the directors that these 800 shares, of which the first call money was not received, those shares has to be forfeited and reissued. So next entry would be for the forfeiture entry. Equity share capital account debit to equity share first call account to forfeited share account. As it is given in a question that the final call was not asked, that means last 2 rupees were not asked by the company, by the shareholders to pay. So the actual price of the 800 shares would become 3 plus 3 plus 2, that means rupees 8, because we are not going to include the premium in this. So total 8 rupees were there and there were 800 shares. So the price of the share, forfeited shares, would be 8 into 800, it becomes 6400 rupees. Okay, and out of this, 4800 rupees has been received by the company, because last 2 rupees, that means call, first call money, was not received, while 6 rupees per share was received by the money out of 800 share, for the 800 of shares. So 6 into 800, it becomes 4800 rupees were received, which should be entered in front of 2 forfeited share account. And the amount which for which there is a which our company was doesn't receive the money at the time of its call, that is 1600, which should be entered in front of 2 equity share first call account. Okay, after forfeiting these shares, next thing is to reissue these shares at 7 rupees per share as per question. So bank account debit, forfeited share account debit to equity share capital account. As it is given that 7 rupees per share were received by the company, so there were 800 shares, so you have to multiply 800 into 7, then you got 5600 to be written in front of bank account in a debit column. And equity share capital account, the cost of the shares which were forfeited, which we have already calculated by multiplying 8 into 800, it is 6400, which should be written in front of equity share capital account in credit column. Now to find out the forfeited share account, we can subtract 5600 from 6400 rupees, which we get 800 rupees. That means we can conclude from here that a company could provide a discount of 4800 rupees, but it has given a discount of only 800 rupees. So the difference amount of these two would be transferred to the capital reserve. So the last entry would be forfeited share account debit to capital reserve. That means the remaining 4000 rupees, which is a capital gain for the company, would be transferred to the capital reserve account. Okay, now it's time for prepare cash book. By looking at the entries, we can make the entries on the debit and credit side of the cash book in a bank column. So can see the first entry. That means bank account debit to share application account, where that is 1,38,000. So again, on the debit side of the cash book, the first entry will be done to share application account, and in the account column, 1,38,000 is to be written. Now the next entry would be the fourth one, bank account debit to equity share allotment account, and the amount is given here 1,84,000. Make that entry on the debit side of the cash book to equity share allotment account, 1,84,000. Okay, now the next entry would be sixth one, bank account debit to equity share first call account, that is 90,400. Make this one on the debit side of the cash book to equity share first call account, 90,400 rupees. Now after this, there is a second last entry, bank account debit, forfeited share account debit to equity share capital account. So in this, on the debit side of the cash book, make the entry by the name to equity share capital account, and 5,600 has to be written here. As you can see in the entry, that in front of bank account amount is 5,600. So 5,600 has to be written in the account amount column on the debit side. Now you have to balance both the sides. So after balancing, on the credit side, you have to write by balance carried down, and the amount of 4,18,000 is to be written here. With this, our question is completed. Thank you.